Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. So this is a pathology video on bronchial asthma with the topic being definition and pathomechanism of bronchial asthma. This is by Dr. CSBR Prasad, Professor of Pathology, Sri Devrajaras Medical College.
Hello students. Today we are going to deal with bronchial asthma. So in gist, bronchial asthma is increased sensitivity of smooth muscle of respiratory tract to certain agents. This increased sensitivity results in stimulation of this smooth muscle causing bronchoconstriction. And this is the basic pathology in bronchial asthma. And because of this bronchoconstriction, patient suffers from recurrent attacks of severe dyspnea, and usually it is associated with wheezing and coughing. So this bronchial asthma is characterized by increased responsiveness, as I told you already, of tracheobronchial tree to various stimuli, potentiating paroxysmal constriction of bronchial tree. So bronchial asthma is a intermittent disease process wherein the smooth muscles of the tracheobronchial tree causes constrictive effect. So patients with bronchial asthma experience, as I was telling, dyspnea, coughing and wheezing, and rarely this coughing, wheezing, dyspnea may be prolonged for hours together, and which we will call as status asthmaticus, and which is sometimes it may cause fatalities. And patients may be asymptomatic in between the attacks. So it is, bronchial asthma is an intermittent disease process. In some cases, the attacks are triggered by exercise, cold, or exposure to allergen. So sometimes exercise also can precipitate bronchial asthma, or exposure to cold again aggravate or precipitate bronchial asthma. And you know this, in our Bangalore city, 50% of the children has got suffer from bronchial asthma because of this pollution, air pollution. So definition, again the same thing, chronic inflammatory disorder of airways that causes recurrent episodes of wheezing, breathlessness, chest tightness, cough, and especially in the night and in the early morning. These symptoms are usually associated with the widespread variable bronchoconstriction and limits the air entry into the lungs, which is reversible process. So there are two three terms which you should be familiar with or specific for bronchial asthma. It is the increased sensitivity of smooth muscle of the respiratory passages, which undergo constriction causing narrowing of the respiratory passages. And second thing is, it is a recurrent episode and it is a reversible process. So these are the three things which you should not forget with reference to bronchial asthma. And this frequency and severity of symptoms may vary from one person to the other. Sometimes it may be mild, intermittent, or sometimes the moderate degrees of dyspnea, or severe, persistent, as you come across in the case of status asthmaticus. And there are some clinical categories which are helpful in diagnosing and treating the patients, that is the steroid dependent and steroid resistant and brittle asthma. Steroid dependent, they are very sensitive to steroids, they can get relief with the steroid usage, and steroid resistant usually do not respond, as their name indicates, to steroids. And brittle asthma, it is very difficult to predict the responsiveness of this asthma to the treatment. And the typical categories, extrinsic, intrinsic and mixed categories. So extrinsic means usually there is allergen mediated, and usually they will have a family history of atopy or allergies. Intrinsic, probably idiosyncratic, which is not predictable how one patient responds to some antigens. And mixed category also exists, wherein extrinsic and intrinsic factors may be playing a role in production of bronchial asthma. And this is an important slide where you should understand, if you look at our immune system, our response to some antigens, usually we will be responding to an antigen by producing IgG variety of antibodies. But some of us may not respond in this way to a particular antigen, instead of producing IgG, such persons may be start producing IgE. So this is what this slide tells you here. So macrophages process the antigen, present to the helper cell, and this helper cell secretes, depending upon your susceptibility, interleukins, which are interleukin 4 or interleukin 12. So if the helper cell is producing interleukin 4, your cell will differentiate into T helper type 2 cell, and if it is producing interleukin 12, it helper cell differentiates into T helper 1 cell. So when there is differentiation towards a T helper 1 cell, they ultimately, the B cells stimulated by T cells produce IgG variety of antibody. On the contrary, if the helper cells are differentiated towards type 2, Th2 type of cells, they stimulate the B cells to produce IgE variety of antibodies. So this skewed production towards as IgE instead of IgG is the basic pathology that is seen in the case of bronchial asthma, and these persons produce IgE, and this you may be knowing that IgE is a cytotrophic antibody. It goes and binds to the mast cell, and only thing is when the person is exposed to second dose of antigen, probably they degranulate. And structural alterations are the ones which are clearly specific for this bronchial asthma. You will call this alterations as airway remodeling. So what is this alterations? Smooth muscle proliferation. So the smooth muscle in the tracheobronchial tree will be hypertrophied and they become thicker. And subepithelial collagen deposition. So collagen deposition subepithelial region will occur in increased frequency. So microscopically you will see thick smooth muscle bundles in the bronchial tree, and the subepithelial collagen will be thicker. So these are called as airway remodeling. So this remodeling is mediated by, as I was telling, Th2 differentiation, and sometimes ADAM33 gene abnormality also may be associated with increased susceptibility for this bronchial asthma. And mast cells, again, mast cell factors which are released from the mast cell may promote these type of changes in the airways. So this this diagram represents normal, and the tracheobronchial tree of the person suffering from bronchial asthma at the bottom. So compare this one. So look at the mucus thickness of the mucus, which is represented by yellow towards the lumen, and a thicker mucus can be appreciated in those person who is suffering from asthma. And look at the irregularity of epithelium lining the bronchial passages. Okay, so here there is lots of goblet cells, and they are producing lots of mucin into the lumen, and in the subepithelial region, appreciate the thickness of the basement membrane and compare with the normal. So basement membrane is very much thickened, is one of the factors for one of the constituents of airway remodeling. You can see thickness of thick basement membrane and lot of inflammatory cells in the subepithelial region, and look at the thickness of the muscle bundles with the normal, and bronchial asthmatic airways will have very thick muscle bundles, and below the muscle bundles there are many glands, and so there is hypertrophy of the glandular element in the bronchial asthma. So coming to allergic asthma, that means this is the most common type of asthma, and there is a family history of allergies, and serum IgE levels will be enormously elevated in these persons. So this is there is some environmental agents which bring about this allergic asthma. So they may be sensitive to dust, pollen, food, animal dander, or anything that can precipitate or induce an attack of asthma. And skin tests are usually positive in these persons. So wheel flare reaction can be appreciated very well with the different allergens, and which can be tested.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe by clicking the button subscribe.